بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عبده المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن بهدي اختفى وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد إن شاء الله today my brothers and sisters may Allah bless you all I'm going to speak inshallah ta'ala about the importance of following the Sunnah of al-Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul, wa ulul amri minkum. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ أَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. And as an Imām, Al-Mubajjal Abu Abdullah Ahmad ibn Hanbal al-Shaybani, may Allah have mercy upon him, said there's over 36 verses, if I don't remember, 36 or 34 verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us clearly to obey Al-Mustafa, the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. And there's no way for us to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correctly, except by referring back to the Al-Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. And as everyone knows, in our time, as I've mentioned, ikhwa and akhawat, may Allah bless you all, we are in a time of fitan wa mihan, times of trials and tribulations, wa'iyadu billah, times when the people of Ba'd and the people of Shara come together, try to distract and divert the Muslims from the true teaching of their Prophet Abul Qasim alayhi salatu wa salam. So they are trying new ways. Before they tried different ways, they were not successful. Now they're coming to us as claiming they are the Muslims, claiming that we are not in need of Sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. Why? Because we cannot trust the Sahaba, even though Allah clearly praised Muhajir and the Ansar. And these guys, as the scholars agree, they are not Muslims, so-called Quraniyun. They are kafara, disbelievers, without any doubt. They have nothing to do with Islam, but they knew that if pretend to be Muslim is easy, would be easy to deceive the Muslim. Because as everyone knows, in a Jumu'ah, if a rabbi has come to give a talk or a priest, no one will take him serious. And, but if someone come, say I'm a Muslim, try to quote the Quran, people will listen to him. So, in ways, ajib, subhanAllah, that our Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam, prophesied about them. He said, will come a time when a person will be sitting in his sofa, lying back in his sofa, and he will say, whatever comes from the book of Allah, we accept it. And the Messenger of Allah said, إِنِّي لَأُوتِيتُ الْقُرْآنَ وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ. Verily, I have been given a Qur'an and something like it, which is a Sunnah. So, as I mentioned, my brothers and sisters, that we have to learn and teach our children, because this shubuhat is not before. You know, doubt before, in order for you to come across a doubt, you have to go to the books. And not everyone do that, but now doubts are in the front face of the people. Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, WhatsApp, you name it. The question that you hear now from the Muslims, subhanAllah, thinking, where do you get this doubt from? Who told you this doubt? And they say, yeah, I saw in Facebook, I was on Instagram, and this, and all of that. You know, the social media, yeah, some good in it, but there's a lot of shar. There's a lot of evil. And alhamdulillah, the haqq is with us. But you still have to learn. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say, O Muhammad, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. Allah will love you and forgive your sins. That's the outcome of following Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran ما كان لمؤمن ولا لمؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا. إذا إيش قضى الله ورسوله أمرا. So this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentioning, everyone can understand, except someone who is a stubborn person. Allah clearly said, it is not befitting for a believer, male or female, if Allah legislates something, for them to go look for another opinion. So Allah said, if Allah and His Messenger legislate something, and we know the Messenger sallallahu legislation is not the Quran. If the Prophet wants to legislate something, that is in the Sunnah. Because Allah said, if Allah legislates something, then the Messenger legislates something. It cannot be both the Quran, because there's no benefit to repeating the same thing. That means Prophet legislated something as well. So that there's many verses. The Messenger of Allah said, Man raghiba an sunnati falaysa minni. Whosoever turns away from my Sunnah, then it's not for me. That whosoever turns away from my Sunnah, it's not for me. And this so-called Qur'aniyun, who are the Qur'aniyun, are the enemies of Qur'an. What is ajib about them? They trust the translation of the Qur'an, but they don't trust Sahaba. So they trust these translators who they never met, but they never trust Sahaba, al-iyadu billah. And what is contradiction, what is contradictory, that those who passed down the Qur'an to us are the Sahaba, which Allah praise. So these guys, ikhwa, this movement started in India. Then spread in Egypt, then Sudan, some countries. So Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned a good point, rahmahu ta'ala. You know the Quran, you know, have you heard this doubt? Christians always say to you, Jesus' name is mentioned more in than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran. Moses, so what? Rather that is not a doubt, that is a proof for us that Quran, Prophet never had control over the Quran. It was not for him to take and put and add. No. It was from Allah. That is a proof Prophet is a true prophet. Because why is he going to mention Jesus' name or Abraham's name more than himself? If someone's a liar, of course, he's going to mention his name. Up this. But surely Quran is not a book to show us a personal Bible of Prophet. No. Quran was a guideline even for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet was being sent to explain the Quran and to give more legislation. You would be. Now, so Ibn Taymiyyah makes a good point. This Quraniyun, they don't believe nothing outside the Quran. They claim even if this something which is mutawatir, what is known by necessity. For example, everyone knows who is Baghdad in Iraq. It's ma'roof, we cannot deny this. Ma'roof Baghdad is in Iraq. In the Quran, Allah has mentioned Prophet Muhammad's name. But Allah doesn't mention his full name. Because of course, the Arab knew who the Quran is referring to. And historically speaking, as Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, Jawab Sahih, there is no one in the history claim he received the Quran except one, subhanAllah. Who? Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abdul Muttalib. SubhanAllah, ajib, you know, there were people named Muhammad, but none of them claimed that, except the Messenger of Allah. So Quran, Allah is going to tell Quraysh his name Muhammad, they know it's Muhammad Abdullah ibn Abdul Muttalib. But for us, they take it from the Sunnah and the books of Tariq. So these guys, they have nothing to stand on. And these guys, they are what they want to do. As I've mentioned now, they change the tactic. They want to make Muslims kuffar, murtadun. How? Claiming that we are Muslims only for the Quran. But they don't follow the Quran. Why? Because if you claim to follow the Quran, Allah said, obey Allah. How we obey Allah, brothers? Quran. Because Allah is going to reveal to you, Quran, obey the Messenger. How are we going to obey the Messenger? Sunnah. But to these donkeys, Hima, said it's Quran as well. So Allah said, obey Allah, it's Quran. Obey the Messenger, Quran as well. It's a fair. Now, subhanAllah. So, likewise, because you know, if you leave the Sunnah now, if you start having doubt about the Sunnah, then what is the next step? As Abu Zur'at al-Razi, al-Imam al-Mubajjal, Na'am rahimahullah ta'ala, when he said about those who speak ill of Sahaba, he said their target is not Sahaba, their target is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Quran. See how the Salaf understood Basira. Nah, it's not, this guy, he doesn't want, he's claiming to be Quran, but he's a liar. Because now, Quran, for example, we have different recitation in the Quran, sahih, Warsh, Naam, and Hafs, and other than that. We have some Mus'haf, Malikis, Maliki and Maliki, some Mus'haf, Naam. So according to you, which one is correct? That's why these people cannot defend Islam. That's why when I spoke to one of them, he said, I'm not here to defend Islam, according to Islam. Whereas he had to put doubt in the Muslims' minds to make them mutaddun. But we know what Prophet said, which is mutawatir hadith. Many companies mentioned it. Unzi al-Qur'an ala sab'ati ahruf. Qur'an was revealed upon seven ways to be recited. Now mutawatir means that is passed down generation after generation. Like it's mutawatir Mecca where? It's in Saudi. Even this Kaddam, Khabith, this man, when I said to him, where's Mecca? He said, allegedly is in Saudi. What's the allegedly? So where is it? Conspiracy now. See, even he said, Prophet maybe was Mushrik before. See, that's why the ulama of Sunnah, may Allah have mercy upon those who have passed away, and may Allah reward those who are still alive. Now, when you see some Muslim, why are you fitting Muslim? Hey, you're fitting Muslim. This is Rafida, Khubada, or this so-called Quran in Khubada. They target to destroy Islam, but you're miskin, jahil, you don't know. Just unite, unite upon Ba'dir wa al-Iyadu Billah. No, we unite upon Haqq. We're not like Christians who, they overlook the clear cut misguidance of their groups. Allah said, Kuntum khayra ummatin, ukhrijat linnas. Na'am ta'mura bil ma'roof wa tanhauna 'anil munkar. As Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah, well, let me translate the verse. Allah said, you are the best people that brought out, you are the best nation that brought out the people. Why? Because you enjoy good and forbid the evil. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala said, the way Quran was passed down to us is not through manuscripts. Because sometimes the person who wrote a manuscript could be tired, mix up something. Rather, if we found the manuscript has mistake, who will bring scholars of Quran to correct it? Because that manuscript, you don't know who wrote it. Maybe the person was weak, he was tired, and you know, back in those days to write his log. So we have what? These scholars, thousands of scholars of Quran, who study thousands from different countries, from India, Africa, Algeria, Africa is Algeria, and from Asia, everywhere. And they come say, no, this is incorrect, this person made a mistake. It's not like Christians and the Jews. Now they write on a manuscript, they don't know who wrote it. That's why we can call to Islam. That's why Islam is the absolute truth. Because we can establish with the tangible proofs and the logical argument, Prophet Allah is a true ilah. Quran is speech of Allah. Prophet is a true messenger. Alayhi salam. But this so-called Quran, you and the Rafi, they're all over the place. So, ikhwa and al-khawat, we have to love the sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salam. And follow the Sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Now the Sunnah, linguistically speaking, is the tariq. Now tariq khayru tariq sayyi. Now Sunnah. Now istilahan or shar'an, legislatively, the meaning of Sunnah, ما نسب إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من قول أو فعل أو إقرار أو خلق أو أخلاق. As for the Islamic definition of Sunnah and the Muhaddithin, that whatever has been attributed to the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam for speech and actions and what his companions did or said, and he approved it, and the way he looked alayhi salatu wasalam, and his conduct, his character alayhi salatu wasalam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Within your prophets, with the Messenger of Allah, there is a good example. And the best example is the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu al-Qasim alayhi salatu wasalam. And look how the Sahaba used to يُعَظِّمُونَ سُنَّةَ الْمُصْطَفَى alayhi salatu wasalam. Even if his own son, said something which goes against Sunnah, he will boycott him. The story of who? Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhuma. His story with his son Bilal. Abdullah ibn Umar said to his son, for his son said, I'm going to prevent a woman coming to the masjid. Abdullah said, لا تفعل فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لا تمنعوا أماء الله مساجد الله. He said, don't do it because I've heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, do not prevent the servants of Allah, meaning the woman here, female servants of Allah, from the masajid. They will come, let them come, don't prevent them. Bilal said, I'm going to prevent them. He said, but Allah, I will not speak to you, never speak to you again. I'll tell you the messenger of Allah said, and he told me, I'm going to do it again. So they said, when he was about to die, Abdullah ibn Umar, Sahabi al-Jaleel, الذي يعظم السنة المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام. يعني he was one of the Sahaba which he did not agree with Hussein, Sahabi al-Jaleel, but I pleased with him when he went to Al-Kufa. And he was the same one who collects these sons. And he said, do not rebel against Yazid. Because I had the message of Allah said, whoever remove his head from the obedience of his leader, then he will die upon the day of ignorance. What does it mean? The day of ignorance, they never used to obey the leaders. And of course, the way we speak about Sahaba, those who made ijtihad and got it wrong, may Allah please with them. Because Allah praised them, and Allah told us to seek forgiveness. And Imam Ahmed, when he was asked about some people who tried to justify rebellion against the leader by what some Sahaba did, he said, what against this individual? Allah told us to keep silent about Sahaba. Look at Imam al-Mubashir, Ahmed ibn Hanbal al-Shaybani. And you have a donkey here, Birmingham, shouts like a donkey. He wants the Muslim country to be destroyed while he's in Birmingham and he's bad, you know, family drinking tea, Pepsi, Coca-Cola, when Muslims killing each other. Look to Libya, Syria, even though we know the leaders may take fear on them, the scholars may take fear on them, but they don't rebel, because they have the power. What happened? As they say, they destroy a country to build a house. Someone was like, someone come in, he destroyed the whole country for the sake of building a house. So you know that. Yeah. So, but the Shaykh Abd ibn Umar became very angry. Likewise, Sahabi, another Sahabi, Sahih Bukhari, the Hadith. He said, قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام الحياء من الإيمان. Shyness is from Iman. So one of the people was sitting there. He said, Ya Sahabi, Ya Rasulullah, we read in a book of Hikam that shyness is type of weakness. He said, I said, the messenger of Allah said, shyness is from Iman. He said, yeah, but he started, he said, get out of here. Until Prophet said, you're telling me about books of philosophers, look how they had jealousy for Sunnah Ta'lim. How Prophet said something, you start bringing aqwal of Aristotle and Plato and Zanadiq fil Ula? How? Now, because it's much better to say, you know, akhi, I don't follow Sunnah correctly, but I know Sunnah is the best way. I'm a sinner. Akhi, this guy is ahsan. Wa afdal. Means someone who say, no, we have to follow Sunnah now. Now, this man knows Sunnah is the best way. But he say, you know, Allah forgive us. It's Allah al-afu al-afi. We make mistakes and we fall short into some stuff. Hada afdal wa ahsan. Means someone say, we don't follow Sunnah at our time. Another, so the Sahabi rebuked him. Another narration. A Sahabi saw a young man playing, you know, when you put a stone in your index and you start throwing it. So he said, don't do it. Prophet said, don't do it. Because you're not going to have an enemy. There's no benefit except you will poke someone's eye or you knock down someone's tooth. So he's the son. He saw him again doing it. He said, but Allah, I'm not speaking to you anymore. I said, Prophet said, do not do it, and you keep doing it. Look how ta'adim of the Sunnah. No, akhi, don't worry. Rafidi, don't worry. Mu'tazili, don't worry. Jahmi, don't worry. Ikhwani, now where? That's why Allah raised Sahaba and the Salaf al-Salih. They had the ghira for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ghira of the Sunnah of Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. So my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. And Imam Shafi'i said, it is ma'roof, well known, established, that is not befitting for a Muslim, if the Sunnah become clear to him, to look for another thing. There's an Imam Shafi'i, man came to him. He said, yeah, Imam, what do you think about, what is your opinion about such and such? He said, the Messenger of Allah said this. He said, what is your opinion though? He said, do you see like I'm wearing a cross or something? The Prophet said, I told the Prophet said this, have you telling me about my opinion? I'm wearing a cross, I'm a priest or a rabbi to you? Nah. So, show you how Sahaba and Tabi'een, the likes of Hassan al-Basri, Sa'id al-Musayyib, Ibn Ahmad al-Hanbal, Shafi'i, Sufyan al-Thawri, Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, Imam al-Salaf, rahimahum Allah ta'ala. From day one, they were made sure no one play with the Sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. When Allah said, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra, wa inna lahu lahafidun, we have sent down the dhikr and we will preserve it. The Sunnah is part of the dhikr. Because Allah has commanded us with the clear commandment to go back to the Messenger of Allah and to obey the Messenger of Allah, correct? By his own life. So what does it mean? So it's Sunnah. Because that commandment of obeying the Messenger of Allah is not just for the Sahaba, it's for everyone. This so-called Quran, you say, no, it's back then. You see how, so be aware of these guys. And teach. Because now, as I mentioned, Shubha is everywhere. Of course, don't approach Shubha to the Billah, no. There's only way of Salaf. But, as I mentioned now, Shubha approach you. And again, as the Nabi alayhi salam said, the fitan will enter people's houses. Sheikh Fawzan and Sheikh Rabi said, internet. And the internet. SubhanAllah, TV, internet, you know, al-iyadu billah. So, and there's many aqwal, the likes of Abu Hanifa, rahimahu ta'ala, when he said, if my speech go against Sunnah, then throw my speech and accept the Sunnah. Na'am, likewise, stated from the Salaf. So, my brothers and sisters, there is no way for us to understand the Quran without going back to the Sunnah. And we have this Zanadiqa saying, no, we'll have to go to Sunnah, but he has no problem to go back to the translator and understand the Quran according to what, how the translator translated it. Because the Quran was not even in English, in Arabic. So, for example, one of them was speaking to him, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said here, نعم قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلة ترضاها فولي وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام. أن الله سيقول السفهاء من الناس ما ولاهم عن قبلتهم التي كانوا عليها. You know Allah سبحانه وتعالى مش القرآن صلى الله to change direction of the قبلة, correct? Because before they used to pray to Aqsa, correct? Now where is the commandment? Where Allah commanded his prophet to pray toward Al-Aqsa? It's not in the Quran. So I said, what is it? He said, no, it's not very important. I said, what do you mean it's not very important? It's a wahi. What is it? It's not in the Quran. Are you claiming the Quran is not completed? Because if you claim, that's the argument. If you claim that the revelation which Prophet Muhammad received is only restricted in the Quran, then you are in a big problem now. Where is the commandment to face Masjid Aqsa is in the Sunnah. Naam. One of them, as the Sheikh mentioned, he said, when I was giving da'wah to one of them, he said, yeah, show me where does it say they used to pray toward Aqsa. He said, no, that's not the point. The point they used to pray to different qibla. Aqsa or not, leave it aside. But the point they used to pray to different qibla. Where is that commandment? Because you kadabun, you claim the revelation only restricted in the Quran. I would say no, the revelation is in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. That's how the ma'roof, that's how the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam accepted it. And Allah said in the Quran, مَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِي جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. whatsoever opposes the message of Allah, after the guidance has become clear to him, and follow the way other than the way of the believers, will lead him to that which has undertaken, and will lead him to the hellfire. What an evil destination. Imam Shafi'i said this is a proof of Ijma', that if you oppose Ijma', you're a sinner. Why? Because Allah connected his punishment to two things. One of the opposing the messenger and going against the believers. He didn't just say if you oppose the messenger, even likewise if you go against the believers. So which believers Allah is talking about here? Because you claim something, I claim something. But we know the believers that Allah praised, who? Sahaba. So do you fall their way? So Qur'an the Arab from no one, except their leaders who cover like them. Likewise the Rafida. Which believers Allah speaking about here? Sahaba, Muhajir al-Ansar, Allah praise. So Alhamdulillah al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ati al-Hadithi wal-Athar Atba' al-Salaf al-Salih. We have Qur'an, Sunnah, Al-Aql ma'ana, Al-Naql ma'ana, Wal-Aql ma'ana, Wal-Fitrat ma'ana. Alhamdulillah. Al-Bid'a al-Aql wa al-Naql. Al-Sunnah, the Qur'an is of them, the Sunnah is of them, the intellectual argument, sound intellectual arguments of them, the fitnas of them, Al-Bid'a, nothing is of them. La aql wa la naql. Naam, so Alhamdulillah, we should be very grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that guide us to the Sunnah of Abu al-Qasim alayhi salatu wa salam. Naam, the way how the Sahaba understood it. And Allah preserved this deen, preserved the Quran, the Sunnah, how this Quran was understood by Sahaba. Naam, barakallahu fikum. Inshallah, so a sister, may Allah bless her, brought some books, important lesson for every Muslim male and female. So I want to give it, but I have to ask questions. There's too many of you here, mashallah. So I want to give the book, but I have to ask questions. So the first question I will ask, you have to raise your hand. If someone says, we don't have to follow Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what is the answer? What is the proof that we have to follow Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Quran? Naam, obey Allah and obey the Messenger, barakallahu fik. And this commandment, is it specific or general?
General.
For me, for you, for people until the day of judgment. Allah is commanding. Naam. So obey Allah, what does it mean?
Follow the Quran.
Quran, obey the Messenger. Sunnah, because it's not with us. Otherwise, it's lahu al-'iyadu billah. For Allah to ask, obey the Messenger, and there's nothing come from the Messenger. نعم قبحهم الله هذا خبثة بارك الله فيك أخيك The second question Sisters you want to ask question خلاص I will ask question for the أخوات but you have to write down the answer نعم if you want you have to write down the answer And inshallah, see the. Yeah, I'm gonna ask a question that's for the sisters. Da'am. The question which Sahabi told his son to not prevent the woman from coming to the masjid? So, write it down. That's a question for the akhawat. So we keep this book here, wait for the answer because I write it down. The third question, which is for the last book, may Allah bless you all my brothers and sisters, and may Allah give us husn al-khatima. What Imam Ahmed said concerning